11 and registered under 0.SES 79. Now the first experiment in Unix lab is basic Unix commands. The aim of this experiment is to execute the basic Unix commands. So there are three types of programs: internal commands, external commands, and shell script. The syntax is given as dollar command line argument one dollar dot argument two. Create a directory with your name, mk directory cristo. Navigate the directory. So cd cristo is the command. So when we give cd cristo, the output is that. Create a file employee details dot text with the following input. First we have to give cat employee details dot text, cat employee details dot text. So now this is how we created the file and display the number of employees working under the software testing domain from the file. So we have to group it: employee details dot text, grep software employee details dot text. So now this is the command that we have given, cat employee details dot text. So the employee details is coming, and then when we give grep, and the output will be 096 RM network 2010. Display the name in a sorted order with the respect of the year of joining. So for that the command is sort underscore k for employee details dot text. So now if you see here 1998 2001 2002 2010, so they are ordered in sorted order. So now we have to create a new file employee details backup dot text with same content as employee details dot text. So for that the command is cp employee details dot text, employee details backup dot text, cat employee details backup dot text. So what will happen is the value here will be copied to backup dot text. Rename the file employee details backup dot text to secure dot text. For that we have to give the command as mp employee details backup dot text secure dot text, cat secure dot text. So the name of the file will be changed, cat secure dot text. In the sense, whatever was there in employee details backup dot text will be displayed here. How many files are available under slash dvp? Cd slash dev is slash wc minus l is the command used. So these are the different files. Display the inode number and access permissions of the file. Ls underscore i cd ls underscore i employee details dot text. So all the permissions will be displayed, mk directory and etc. And then we have to give ls employee details underscore one. So after this, all the read are the permissions. Now the next one is to display the current time and display the July month of the year 2017. Time, date, calculate July 2017, cal 7/2017. So this is the July's calendar. So July 2017 would be like this. Display the user names, whoever is logged into the system now, and save it into the file logs.txt. So who's or cat greater than logs.txt, cat logs.txt. So this is how it will get stored. This is a list of all the users. How many words are present in the file employee details.txt? WC underscore W employee underscore details.txt. So when we give that 21 employee details.txt, find the terminal number you are using, TTY slash DEV slash BTS slash 256. So the terminal number is DEV slash BTS slash 440. So TTY is the command used. Then the next one is create an empty file and input the contents into the file. Display the first three lines of the file. Head underscore 3 secure dot text is the command. When we give that, employee details, employee name, project, year is displayed, 096 RM network 2010, 097 Vijay Hadoop 1998. Display the content under your home directory including hidden files. Ls underscore a is the command used. So when we give ls underscore a, all the files are displayed. Create an alias name unhidden from the command to display files including hidden alias. Mk directory hr history alias unhidden equals to ls underscore a. So to become unhidden, what is the process id of the shell you are using? Echo dollar dollar will display it. So the process id is 23699. Create a directory named hr, then move all the files from your home directory to the hr. So mk directory new hr, md hr new hr, md hr new hr. Then change the mode of the owner alone with the execute function for secure.txt. chmod u plus x secure.txt. chmod u plus x secure.txt. So we've done. So all the commands are executed successfully. That's it. This is the end of my experiment.